Curious Droid presents the top 10 fastest computers in the world. How do they compare to a PC or iPad Pro? If you need to model things like the world's weather, nuclear reactions, molecular dynamics, or simulate the first few seconds after the Big Bang, you're going to need some pretty serious computing power. But just how much more powerful are the top 10 supercomputers compared to the PC on your desktop or an iPad Pro, for example? In this video, we'll see just how powerful supercomputers have become, but first we need to know, how do you measure a computer's performance? There are lots of ways to do this, but the most common for high-performance systems, and the simplest to understand, is to measure how many calculations per second they are capable of. The unit of measurement is called the FLOP, or floating point operation. A FLOP is a calculation that would be either adding, subtracting, multiplying, or dividing two numbers with decimal points in them. For example, 10.545 multiplied by 6.387 would be a single flop. Modern computers can do this billions of times a second. At the time of making this video in February 2016, the latest iPad Pro with the A9X dual-core CPU is capable of around about 1.5 gigaflops. That's 1,500,000 flops per second. A typical $1,000 PC with a single Intel 5820 6-core CPU is capable of around 100 gigaflops, that's 66 times more than an iPad Pro. You can measure the performance of your own Intel-based PC or Mac or mobile device with the same type of LINPACK software as they use to benchmark supercomputers. Just look for the link in the description of this video. Because supercomputers are so much more powerful, they are measured in petaflops. One petaflop is equal to 1,000 teraflops, and one teraflop is equal to 1,000 gigaflops. And remember, our PC was 100 gigaflops, and the iPad Pro 1.5 gigaflops. A petaflop is equal to about 1 million billion calculations per second. One estimate suggests that it would take a human about 32 million years to complete the same task. Now we know what an everyday computing device that you or I own is capable of, let's see how it compares to the top 10 supercomputers in the world. All the figures given were correct as of November 2015 and gathered from the top 500 list of supercomputers. At number 10 we have the Stampede supercomputer at the Texas Advanced Computing Center at the University of Texas in the United States. This supercomputer is made by Dell and has a maximum LINPACK performance of 5.1 petaflops. That's the equivalent of 51,000 of our $1,000 PCs or 3.4 million iPad Pros. It has 462,462 processing cores and 192 terabytes of RAM and consumes approximately 4.5 megawatts of power at maximum performance. At number 9 we have the Shaheen 2 at the King Abdullah University of Science and Technology in Saudi Arabia. This supercomputer is made by Cray and has a maximum LINPACK performance of 5.5 petaflops. That's the equivalent of 55,000 of our PCs or 3.66 million iPad Pros. It cost approximately $51 million to buy and install. It has 196,608 processing cores and 790 terabytes of RAM and consumes a maximum power of 2.8 megawatts. At number 8 is the Hazel Hen at the HLRS in Stuttgart, Germany. This is another supercomputer made by Cray Incorporated, and it has a maximum LINPACK performance of 5.6 petaflops and is the fastest supercomputer in the European Union. That's the equivalent of 56,000 of our PCs or 3.73 million iPad Pros. It has 185,088 processing cores and consumes a maximum of 3.2 megawatts of power. At number 7 we have the Piz Daint at the Swiss National Supercomputing Center at Lugano, Switzerland. The Piz Daint, named after a nearby mountain, is yet another Cray-built supercomputer, and it has a maximum LINPACK performance of 6.2 petaflops. That's the equivalent of 62,000 of our PCs, or 4.13 million iPad Pros. It has 115,984 processing cores and 169 terabytes of RAM, and consumes a maximum of 2.3 megawatts of power. At number 6 is the Trinity, at the Los Alamos National Laboratory, New Mexico, United States. Yes, this is yet another Cray supercomputer, and it has a maximum LIM pack performance of 8.1 petaflops. That's the equivalent of 81,000 of our PCs, or 5.4 million iPad Pros. It has 301,056 processing cores and cost approximately $174 million. At number 5, we have the Mira Blue Gene Q at the US Department of Energy, Argonne National Laboratory, Illinois, United States. This supercomputer was built by IBM and has a maximum LIMPAC performance of 8.5 petaflops. That's the equivalent of 85,000 of our PCs, or 5.66 million iPad Pros. It has 786,432 processing cores, 768 terabytes of RAM, and consumes a maximum of 3.9 megawatts of power. No cost has been released by IBM, but it was believed to have been around $50 million. At number 4 is the K computer at the Riken Advanced Institute for Computational Science at Kobe, Japan. Built by Fujitsu, the K supercomputer has a maximum LIMPAC performance of 10.5 petaflops. That's the equivalent of 105,000 of our PCs, or 7 million iPad Pros. It has 705,024 processing cores and 1,410 terabytes of RAM and consumes a maximum of 12 megawatts of power. To give you an idea of the performance of this machine, a simulation of the human heart, which had taken 2 years, was accomplished in just 1 day on the K computer. At number 3 is the Sequoia Blue Gene Q at the Lawrence Livermore National Laboratory, California, United States. The number 3 on the top 10 list is built by IBM and has a maximum LIMPAC performance of 17.1 petaflops. That's the equivalent of 171,000 of our PCs, or 11.4 million iPad Pros. It has 1,572,864 processing cores, 1,572 terabytes of RAM, and consumes a maximum power of 7.8 megawatts. The primary use of a Sequoia is for nuclear weapons simulation, but it would also be used for study of the human genome, climate change, and astronomy, to name but a few. At number 2 is the Titan at the Oak Ridge National Laboratory, Tennessee, United States. Another Cray-built supercomputer is at number 2 on the list and has a maximum LIMPAC performance of 17.5 petaflops. That's the equivalent of 175,000 of our PCs, or 11.6 million iPad Pros. It has 560,640 processing cores, 710 terabytes of RAM, and consumes a maximum of 7.1 megawatts of power. At the number 1 slot on the top 10 list of the world's most powerful supercomputers is the Tianhe 2, or Milky Way 2, at the National Supercomputer Center at Guangzhou City, Guangdong Province, China. This was built by the Chinese National University of Defense Technology and has a maximum LIMPAC performance of 33.8 petaflops. That's the equivalent of 338,000 of our PCs, or 22.53 million iPad Pros. It has 3,120,000 processing cores and 1,024 terabytes of RAM and consumes a maximum power of 17.8 megawatts. The Tianhe 2 has been the top supercomputer for the past 3 years running now in the top 500 list, which comes out twice a year. So where do we go from here? Well, if anyone can figure out how to build a real quantum computer, IBM have previously stated that if one could be made with just 50 quantum bits or qubits that could detect both types of errors and scale to large systems, no combination of today's top 500 supercomputers could successfully outperform it. Until then, we'll look forward to the first 1,000 petaflop or 1 exaflop machine in hopefully around 2025. Thanks for watching, and I hope you enjoyed the video. If you did, then don't forget to please thumbs up and subscribe for more. And if you have any ideas for videos you'd like to see, then please let us know in the comments below.